بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إن شاء الله today we'll speak about the important تحريرات for ورش. التحريرات. تحريرات means that for example I'll give you بس example before we start. For example, I told you that we will recite the mad badal 2 and 4 and counts for wash. That wash can recite the mad badal 2 or 4 or 6. 2 or 4 or 6 for badal. And I also told you, for example, that wash recite has the fath and taqleem. For example, in dawat al-iya, he can recite with fath and he can recite with taqleem. What is the meaning of tahrirat? Tahrirat that I'll tell you. For example, if you recite with something, you have to do something like this. But for example, if you recite مد بدل with two counts, you will read ذوات الياء with فتح. If you recite four counts, you will read with تقليل. If you recite the six counts, you will read فتح and تقليل. You have two options, فتح and تقليل for ذوات الياء. Okay, like this. This is the تحريرات. For now, I'll give you what are the samples of the تحريرات. طب the first thing if the مد بدل comes with ذوات الياء خلاص if you do مد بدل two counts you will make ذوات الياء four counts you make ذوات الياء with فتح if you make مد بدل four counts you will make ذوات الياء with تقليل if you make مد بدل six counts you will make ذوات الياء فتح and تقليل طب for example if it comes in آية for example وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرَ But now I do two counts with بد بدل and then I do أَبَى with فتح. طب I will recite now with four counts in آدم and with تقليل in أبى. So I'll say وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ أَبَى I do four and then تقليل in أبى. طب if I do آدم six counts, so I will do in أبى four فتح and تقليل. If I meet آدم six counts, I will meet ذوات الياء in أبى فتح and تقليل. So I will say وإذ قلنا للملائكة اسجدوا لآدم فسجدوا إلا إبليس أبى رجس يبقى if مد بدل you are recited with two counts if you are writing meeting with ختمة with two counts من مد بدل you will write you will recite ذوات الياء with فتح If you are remitting your khatma with four counts in badal, you will recite ذوات الياء with taqleel. If you recite your khatma with six counts in مد بدل, you will make ذوات الياء with fath and taqleel. Right. This is one point. Another point, if ذوات الياء comes first and the badal comes second, you will say in one ayah, and if it comes in one ayah, for example, خلاص, you will say you will make fath in ذوات الياء and you will make آدم two and six times if it comes in one A. So you will say فتلقى آدم من ربه كلمات or آدم من ربه كلمات you make fath and you make the مد بدل two and six times. But if you make تقليل if you make تقليل You will make ذوات الياء four and six. So you will say فَتَلَقِّي آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ and you will say آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ But this is in case if it comes in one ayah and the ذوات الياء comes first and then the مد بدل comes second. If you recite with فتح فتلقى, you will make مد بدل two and six times. If you recite فتلقى with تقليل, you will make آدم four and six times. Okay? Another point. If ذوات الياء comes with a lean al-mahmuz. A lean al-mahmuz, which is like shay. Okay? If you recite with fatah of dawat al-ya, you will make the lean mahmuz 4 and 6 times. And if you make taqleel in dawat al-ya, you will make also lean al-mahmuz 4 and 6 times. But either you make fatah or you make taqleel, you will make the lean mahmuz 4 and 6 counts. Okay? For example, هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَسَوَّاهُنَّ 7 سَمَاوَاتٍ وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ 4 and 6. Now I will make with taqleel. هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا ثُمَّ اسْتَوِي إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَسَوَّاهُنَّ 7 سَمَاوَاتٍ وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ 4 and 6. Okay, if I recite first with fatah and with 4 and 6 in shay, then I may recite with taqleel and with 4 and 6 in shay. Another point. If the badal comes first and al-leen al-mahmuz comes last, and if there is an ayah and the badal comes first and then the leen mahmuz comes in the same ayah but in the last. If you recite mad badal with 2 and 4 counts, alas, you will make the leen mahmuz 4 counts. If you recite mad badal with 6 counts, you will read the leen al-mahmuz 4 and 6 counts. So I'll say now 2 and 4, then with 4 counts in mahmuz. You'll say inna makkanna lahu fil ardi wa ataynahu min kulli shay'in sababa. This is 2 counts. What if I do وآتينا, but the better 4, I'll make also 4 counts in shay. وآتيناه من كل شيء سببا. Now I'll recite with 6 counts in آتينا and with 4 and 6 counts in shay. وآتيناه من كل شيء سببا شيء سببا. But if there is an A, and then the mad badal comes first and lean mahmuz comes last, if you are reciting with 2 counts, you will make 4 counts in shay. If you are reciting with 4 counts in atayna, you will make 4 counts in shay. If you are reciting with 6 counts in badal, you will make 6 counts in shay. 4 and 6 counts in shay. If you are reciting with 6 counts. Okay? If the leen mahmuz comes first and the badal comes last, okay? But if the leen mahmuz in an ayah comes first and then the badal comes last, okay? If you recite the leen mahmuz with 4 counts, you will recite 2 and 4 and 6 counts in badal. If you recite the leen mahmuz with 6 counts, you will recite 6 counts in badal. So if you say وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ, this is 4 counts. مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَا يَؤُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا. 2 or 4 or 6. وَلَا يَؤُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا, or وَلَا يَؤُودُهُ حفظهما. So what if you recite بشيء 6 times? You will come and recite يأوده 6 times. You will say ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما. Like this. If I recite 6 counts in shay, then I make madal 6 counts. Right. Another point. What if the badal comes with اللين المهموز العارض للسكون المهموز العارض للسكون المهموز. If you recite two counts in مد بدل, you will recite the عارض للسكون مهموز with six then four then two. Okay? If you recite مد بدل four, you will recite اللين المهموز العارض للسكون المهموز العارض للسكون المهموز four then six six. You will recite the six. If you recite مد بدل four counts, you will recite العارض للسكون المهموز with six then four. If you recite البدل six counts, you will recite النيل المهموز with six counts. So you will say two counts in آمنا, then I'll recite now with two counts. I'll say وَإِذَا لَقُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَالُوا آمَنَّا وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَى شَيَاطِينِهِمْ قَالُوا إِنَّا مَعَكُمْ إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مُسْتَهْزِئُونَ. I recite two counts in amanna, then I make six, then four, then two. Like this, you have to start with the six, then four, then two. But now I recite with four counts in amanna. وَإِذَا لَقُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَالُوا آمَنَّا وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَى شَيَاطِينِهِمْ قَالُوا إِنَّا مَعَكُمْ إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مستهزئون. But I make amanna four counts. Then when I come to مستهزئون, which is عارض للسكون مهموز, I recite it with six, then four. But now I recite with amanna six counts. وإذا لقوا الذين آمنوا قالوا آمنا وإذا خلوا إلى شياطينهم قالوا إنا معكم إنما نحن مستهزئون. يبقى when I recite مد بدل six times, when I come to مستهزئون, I make it six times. Okay? Fine. Another point. The word جبارين, which comes in one آية, قالوا يا موسى إن فيها قوما جبارين. Plus this A. If you recite with Fath in Musa, when you come to Jabbarin, you will make it Fath or Taqleel. If you recite Taqleel of Musa, when you come to Jabbarin, you will make Fath or Taqleel. So you will say, قالوا, this is, يعني, this word is an exception. قالوا يا موسى إن فيها قوما جبارين or جبارين. Like this. فتح then فتح and تقليل فتح in موسى then فتح and تقليل in جبارين. طب now I recite with تقليل of موسى. قالوا يا موسى إن فيها قوما جبارين or جبارين. خلاص when I recite تقليل in موسى I have فتح or تقليل in جبار. طب another word which is the word جار. Also this is one of the exceptions. Okay. If I recite, يعني this is by, it has many, يعني it has this table, يعني. If I recite شيء دليل مهموس with four counts, I will recite with فتح and I recite جار with فتح and تقليل. If I recite four counts in شيء دليل مهموس, يعني I recite with تقليل and with تقليل of جار. If I recite six counts in شيء, I will recite with فتح of the ذوات الياء and with فتح and تقليل in جار. And if I recite with six counts in شيء, I'll recite with تقليل and with تقليل of the ذوات الياء and with تقليل in جار. Yeah, and you have to study this table because I know it's confusing. Just study this table in these words, جبارين and جار. This is exceptions, يعني. This is not a general rule. It is an exception for these two words. But just study this table. Now I recite with four counts in لين مهموز and ذوات الياء with فتح and فتح and تقليل in جر. So I'll say وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَبِذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينِ وَالْجَارِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى. Or I would say وَالْجَارِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى. Okay, and فتح and تقليل in جر. But now I recite with four counts in شيء and with the second point, يعني. خلاص؟ and تقليل of ذات الله and تقليل of جبري. The second point. واعبدوا الله ولا تشركوا به شيئا وبالوالدين إحسانا وبذي القربى واليتامى والمساكين والجار. But now I make with the plea. But now I will recite the third point, which is شيئا six times. I will say واعبدوا الله ولا تشركوا به شيئا وبالوالدين إحسانا وبذي القربى واليتامى والمساكين والجار فتح or تقليل والجار like this. But now I recite the four points. The four point which is a تقليل in Quran. I'll say وَاعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَبِذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينِ وَالْجَارِ. خلاص يبقى this is the fourth point. But just study this table in these two words which is جبارين and جار. But what I want to know in general, خلاص, if you are reciting with two counts in, and if you study meeting khatma for warsh and you are reciting for warsh, and you decide that you will recite with two counts in Madd Badr. So whenever comes a word that has fatha and taqleel, you will recite with taqleel only. With fatha on. Why? Because you are reciting with Madd Badal with two counts. But if you decide to make, but if you are reciting with two counts in Madal, you will recite with fatha. Now, what if you are reciting with four counts in Badal? You will recite with taqleef. Now, what if you are reciting with six counts in Badal? You will recite with fatha and taqleef. But this is the first point that I want you to know. The second point that I want you to know, that if you are reciting either with fatḥ or with taqlīl, when you come to shay, you will make it four and six counts. Okay, this is the second point that I want you to know. طيب, okay, طيب. Also, if there is an ayah and the lean mahmud, the badal comes before the lean mahmud. If you were reciting with two counts, when you come to badal lean mahmud, you will make four counts. But what if you are reciting with four counts? You will make only four. But what if you are reciting with six counts? You will make four and six counts if you are reciting with six counts. Okay. Okay. But this is the second. The second thing that I want you to know, okay? Also, what I want you to know, important, like mustahzi'un, if it comes at the end of the ayah, it's called arad l-sukun al-badr. If you were reciting the madd badal with two counts, when you come to mustahzi'un, you will make six, then, okay? You have to do it by order, then four, then two. But what if you are reciting four counts in amanna? You will make mustahzi'un six, then four. But what if you are reciting amanna with six counts, the badal, you will recite only mustahzi'un with six. So in order to make it easy for you, for example, if you were reciting, you decide that you are reciting in two counts, that the badal. Whenever there is comes word that has fatha and taqlil, you will recite with what? With fatha, as we said now, okay? If a word okay, if it comes shy, you will recite with if it comes shy, you will recite it with four counts. Okay, but what if you are reciting with mad badal four counts? Okay, mad badal four counts. You will whenever a word that has fatḥ al taqlīl, you will recite with taqlīl. Okay, because we said we have recite with taqlīl. Okay, and if I'm sorry, and I repeat again, if you are reciting mad badal two counts, whenever a word that has mad, if you are reciting mad badal two counts, whenever a word that has fatha and taqlil, you will recite with fatha. Okay, but what if comes like muzdahzi'un, you will make six, then four, then two. Stop. Another thing, if you are reciting, for example, your khatna with four counts in badr. Thus, whenever a word that has fatha and taqlil, you will recite it with taqlil. Now, what if you comes to mustahzi'un, you will recite it six, then four. Now, what if you are reciting murukhatma with six counts? Whenever a word that has fatha and taqlil, you will do the two things. Okay? And when it comes to mustahzi'un, you will make 6 rounds. Okay? That's it. And I want you that's to know these rules. This is the general rules. And to know the two words that has the exceptions, which is jabbarin and jar. And whenever an ayah comes, yani as for example, madde badal comes first and then lim mahmuz comes last, you have to look at these rules. If it comes in the same ayah. If it doesn't come in the same ayah, it will be easy. And if you are reciting 2 counts, you will make it fatah. If you are reciting 4 counts, you will make it taqleel. If you are reciting 6 counts, you will make it 6 or 4. You will make fatha and taqleel. If you are reciting 6 counts, you will make fatha and taqleel. Yeah? But it will be easy. But if it comes in the same ayah, you will follow this. This is the important tahrirat for Rosh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. طيب